At this point, we have done our first set of verification checks. We have checked that our results are consistent with the mathematical model that we are looking to solve. The next set of checks is to look at the level of numerical errors. And as I talked about in the pre-analysis, there are two major kinds of numerical errors. One is the linearization error, and the other is a discretization error. If I go to a slide from the pre-analysis where I was talking about discretization and linearization, you end up with a set of algebraic equations that are nonlinear, and you have to solve them by linearizing it. And you reduce the linearization error by iterating and updating your guess values for the velocity, pressure, etc., until your aggregate mass, momentum, energy imbalances are below tolerance. And if I go to Fluent, the solver, and I look at monitors, so let me go into monitors and residual, okay, and I've double clicked on both of those, and I say plot, I can see, you know, how the residuals decrease. So if I look at the continuity residual, you can think of that as the aggregate mass imbalance. So it's looking at the mass imbalance for each cell, and it's adding it all up and it's normalizing it. And it always normalizes in the first few iterations, you know, it says that whatever imbalance I get, that's of order one. So that's reduced by six orders of magnitude because we set our criteria to six. And you can also see, for instance, the epsilon imbalance has also dropped by about six orders of magnitude. Some of the others have dropped by less than that. My own experience has been that, you know, dropping these imbalances down to 10 to the power of minus 6 typically, you know, gives you an acceptable level of linearization error. So we'll take that as a best practice. By the way, the default is 10 to the power of minus 3. And in my own experience, you know, that's in many cases is not sufficiently low level of imbalances, and so your linearization error might be significant. The other thing you can do is track the drag coefficient and see how that changes when you reduce the imbalances by three orders of magnitude, say, and I show you how to do that in the laminar pipe flow case in my free online course. Okay, so we'll say, going back here, we'll say, okay, you know, we've dropped our imbalances, technically they're called residuals, down to 10 to the power of minus 6, and a linearization error is small enough. So let's turn our attention to the discretization error. There are two things we can do to reduce that. First is to make sure that we're using a second order scheme. So in going from the integral to the algebraic equations, you introduce a discretization error, and you can do that using, you know, first order discretization or second order discretization. Don't worry about the details. But if you use first-order discretization, then your discretization error goes, you know, proportional to your mesh spacing. So if I decrease the mesh spacing by half, the error reduces by half. If I use second order, it actually, you know, if I reduce the mesh spacing by half, the error goes down by a factor of 1/4. So I'll go here, and I'll go under methods and make sure that everything is second order, okay? So that's one thing I can do quite easily. And the challenge is that, you know, as you go to more complicated problems, the iterations won't converge when you go to second order, which is where you drop it to first order. But here, second order works. And then the other thing we can do is use more control volumes or cells as refine the mesh. So let me show you how to do that. And I'll go to my project page. In fact, let me get out of Fluent here. Go to the project page, and I'll highlight results. I'll right click on results and say duplicate. Okay, and I'll call that mesh 2. And it's duplicated the whole thing, but the mesh and the geometry are a reference to the original one. So if I want to change the mesh, I need to get rid of this connection. Okay, and let me go into the mesher. And if I look at the mesh, so if I zoom in here using the right mouse button and highlight the mesh, okay, I have, so if I go to the edge sizings, I have 30 divisions in the radial direction, okay, and the mesh looks like that. So instead of refining it, what I'll do is I will actually coarsen it and see the effect of that. And the takeaway is that, you know, often in complex geometries, you're trying to get away with coarse meshes, and the discretization error might be too large. So I'll go under edge sizing and change that to 15 divisions. Okay, so I'm actually coarsening the mesh. And then this is the sizing for in the axial direction. And there I used a size of 30 millimeters. So each division, you know, this length is 30 millimeters. So I'll double that. Again, in the interest of coarsening. So I'll say 60 millimeters. And then I'll say update the mesh. And the mesh is coarser. And if I come back, come here and look at the number of elements, it's of the order of 1530. And remember, so that means that you have, you know, so that's a number of cells. Elements is finite element methodology. It's the same thing. So we have around 1,500 little chunks, and at the cell center of each of those chunks, you need to calculate seven values. And so, you know, Fluent needs to solve that many algebraic equations. Okay, and then let's redo the solution on this coarser mesh. And I'll go back to the project page and I'll say refresh so that the new mesh comes into the solver, and I'll do that. I will do that for solution two. And I typically start the solution, the solver from solution, because it loads in all the previous data as well as the settings. And let me go to methods and make sure everything's second order. And then I'll go to initialization and reinitialize the solution and run the calculation. And you see you know, when you coarsen the mesh, it'll actually converge faster. So you can drop the linearization error more quickly on coarser meshes. And then, so I'll go back here and now a neat thing is I can take my original solution and drag it to the new results and say refresh. And so all my plots, I can see, you know, the old result as well as the new result. And then start results for mesh 2. And the solver has the license, so I'll say request license. And so here I see, you know, I have two cases, forced convection, original one, and mesh two. And I can, for instance, if I come here and go to my original temperature contours, and I'll go to two views, and I'll say, I'll deselect this, I'll select synchronize camera, and select Z, okay? So mesh two, here's the temperature contours. And then in the original mesh, if I want to get that, I'll click here and I'll click on temperature. I'll get rid of the wireframe. So you can see, so this is mesh two. So, you know, you can see that there is, it's almost the same. I don't see a noticeable difference. What about the wall temperature? So if I go here and double click on wall temperature. Again, there is not that much of a difference, even though I'm using a coarser mesh. And I was looking at the centerline velocity. Again, there's not much of a difference. However, if I look at the wall shear, so let me duplicate this. And let me say wall shear and complain about that. So let me call that my wall shear. And go to my wall shear and plot wall shear in the axial direction. And here you see, you know, there is more of a change, and especially near the inlet. So things like wall shear, where you're actually differentiating your interpolated solution, you know, the error increases, and those results are going to be more sensitive to the mesh. I'll save the project. I'll request the license. And by the way, you can export all this to Excel. So if I click on export and go to an appropriate, you know, folder, I can save it as a CSV file, and then I can do all my plots in Excel. So that was a demonstration of how, you know, one could check the linearization error as well as the discretization error. And really, you want to do it on a third mesh that is more refined, and make sure that, you know, your results are unchanged between the original mesh and the refined mesh.